tutorial, I'm going to talk about while loops in Python. So, this is a project, helloworld.py, right? And now, in this project, a while loop is such that till when the condition is true, it will keep on executing some program or some code which we will assign to the while loop. For demonstrating a while loop, I'll just make a variable and give the name as I, just for demonstrating, and then I'll just give the value as 0. After this, for making a while loop, you need to use a keyword known as the while, and after while, just add a space and then the condition. So I'll just show you. Let me open a simple. Here I'll just type the while condition. So this is the format of while loop. And remember to indent it. So this will be the format of while loop. So you can just go here and just say while. I'll just say I is lesser than 10, or suppose 5 here. And then you can just add a colon, and when you press enter, my text editor or PyCharm will automatically indent it. But if you are using something like Notepad, Gedit, then you need to indent it manually. So after this, you can just type in the code. So I'll just print I. So I'll just say print I. After this, now if you run the program, you can see it is going on printing 0. So you can just stop the program. So as you can see, it is going on printing 0. So you can just stop by just incrementing I. So you can just increment I or add 1 to I by just add 1 or any other number. Incrementing means increasing the value. So I'll just say I plus equals to 1. So plus equals to is the shortcut for I is equal to I plus 1. So this is the shortcut. It can be typed as plus equals to 1. So after this, now when you run the program, you can see that it is printing 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, first time when Python sees I, it gives it some space. After that, when it sees a while loop and the condition is I is lesser than 5, so it will print I and then add 1 to I. And then go back again to the starting and then check if it is true, and then again print I and then increment I. So this goes on for 5 times, and after that, when it reaches the level that it is equal to 5, it stops or breaks out of the loop. So I can just demonstrate it by adding a print out of the while loop, and then I can just say loop break or escaped. Now when you run this, you can see that it is first printing 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and then loop break or escape. Now if you type lesser than or equal to, now when you run the program, you can see that it is printing till 5. As now the is equal to operator is also there in the condition. These are the basics of while loop. In the next tutorial, I'll show you how to make a very awesome guessing game with while loop, if statements, and many other things we have learned so far.